I'm Andrew, I play guitar.
Dennis, go!
I'm Dennis, I play bass.
Daniel, drum, sing, go!
I'm also Daniel. Oh, yeah, no. I'm Kenzo, and I play synth and guitar.
And we're Buddha Trixie! Following what happened.
Marry the pug. Kill the harmonica.
Kill the green. Yeah.
So me and Dennis have been friends since like first grade, and then in like fifth grade I started playing guitar, and Dennis and I would play together, and then we added Daniel into the group in like seventh grade. Maybe I'm not doing a good job.
No, you're fine, dude. Daniel was in my seventh grade math class, and was always like drumming on the tables. And just,
I played
like,
rock band. I was really good at rock band. I was like 17th in the world at rock band drums.
Only 17?
I thought it was 12.
I thought it was 12 too.
Well, I don't know. It changes because I don't remember.
You would just be belting out songs in the middle of class, and I just figured like I need that enigmatic presence. So why not?
What about KENZO?
Yeah, come on, Dennis.
Come on, you got
Kenzo. I met Dennis up at UC Davis, and we became friends, and we found out we were both like interested in music, and he invited me to come down and play with him. That's it. And the rest is history.
Well, I'm most comedic in my class.
No, you're not!
No, this is ridiculous. I was most comedic in my class, and prop jester and an improv, so I just want to put that out there.
Yeah, you're such
a oh my god.
A real thing.
You're so...
Don't name a particular band. Goth
metal band opened up for us at a show at Soma.
You're still getting too specific.
They were playing first.
Anyway, there's this band. They have all this face paint and stuff and like dead babies on stage. And it's just like really creepy.
Yeah.
And then after their set, I'm pretty sure this is what we saw, but it seemed like their bassist was on the back of his car. Or was
he sitting on his amp with his head in his hands?
He was sitting on the back of his amp like this, basically just crying. And then like from what I heard, like everyone like wasn't into the set, so maybe that was his reaction to people not liking his set.
Was that the show where they tried to get the mosh?
It was just really intense.
Yeah, they were like, mosh you pussies!
Yeah, actually, like when nobody was reacting, they were just like...
They yelled, mosh you pussies.
Yeah, and then they were crying on their amps backstage, so that was a little bit of a strange sight.
You're the romantic.
I guess I just want to be there for that 10 or 12 year old kid who's like looking for that thing, like that reason to like shove them to go for music or anything. Or this affect them the same way that like a huge band would be like impacting me right off the bat, like Led Zeppelin or somebody. I might have a job.
Yeah, I'd definitely have like an internship and it would be boring.
Some cubicle somewhere.
You'd be doing improv.
We'd do an improv. Yeah.
A decision. It was just like we were so into music and we loved music so much, and we started getting really good. And so we were just like, we're already playing music together, so we might as well make it.
It's just like our thing to do when we hung out anyway. That just became our
I remember in like 8th or 7th grade when I joined, I was like, oh, this is gonna be awesome. Girls are gonna like me now. But that didn't really change. So,
come on.
Man,
this is like
swimming.
No, come on, guys.
I don't want to tour with Led Zeppelin because they just wreck us every night.
Dude, just getting wrecked with Led Zeppelin?
Wow. But like, true, like, who would want to party with? I guess Led Zeppelin.
Like, party so hard. I feel like I really want to meet Kevin Parker.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Tame and Paul would be really cool to play with.
What about Beach House guys, too?
We're way too loud for Beach House. Yeah, I think final answer, war. Ready? Are you ready?
Sorry, I don't know what's happening.
You know what's up.
Yeah.
This is the outro to our interview. Spicy boys!